Control Valves in Pipeflow Expert. In this video, we aim to go over the three different types of control valves that can be added to a Pipeflow Expert model. These include a flow control valve, a pressure reducing valve, and a back pressure valve. You can add a control valve to a pipe by either using the Add Flow Control button here and then selecting the pipe, by right-clicking on the pipe and using the menu, or by selecting a pipe and clicking the Add Edit Control Valve button on the pipe pane. All three methods will open the Set Control Data window, where you can select a valve type and assign a name or reference number. Firstly, looking at flow control valves. These are used to control the flow rate through a particular pipe. The user can enter the desired flow rate of, say, 200 US gallons per minute, and optionally define an allowable pressure drop range across the valve. If we save the flow control valve back to the pipe, a symbol now appears on the drawing. When a control valve of any type is added to a pipe, the Include checkbox next to the button on the pipe pane is selected. To remove the flow control data from the calculations, simply clear the Include checkbox. The control valve icon is then greyed out on the drawing. Now, if we re-include the flow control valve and solve this system, the software will calculate the additional pressure loss introduced by the flow control valve to limit the flow rate in the pipe to the value we set. The pressure loss across the FCV is reported in the results log here and can also be viewed on the results drawing by hovering over the valve, where an equivalent CV or KV value is also given. Next, we will look at pressure reducing valves. Pressure reducing valves reduce the pressure at the end of the pipe by introducing a pressure loss. In this example, we will include a PRV on pipe 1 to reduce the pressure at the outlet node 2. Let's first calculate the model to see what maximal pressure we would get at this node. The pressure at node 2 is calculated to be as high as 70 psi gauge. So let's introduce the PRV to limit the pressure to 20 psi. The elevation is set to the elevation at the following node, since the software assumes the valve is placed at the end of the pipe. Again, we can solve the system and hover over node 2 to see that the pressure has now been reduced to 20 psi gauge, and the valve has added a pressure loss of 116.73 feet of head to limit the pressure at this point. Pressure valves are used to maintain the pressure at the start of a pipe by again introducing a pressure loss. Solving this example, we are presented with a warning in the results log, which shows that the pressure at node 3 would need to be less than atmospheric pressure, which can be problematic if, say, we require a certain minimum pressure to deliver the 1000 US gallons per minute flow rate at this outlet. We will include a back pressure valve on pipe 4 and enter a pressure value of 20 psi gauge. Again, the elevation is set to the same elevation as the node at the start of the pipe. Let's solve this example now with the BPV. Introducing the valve, we can see that the pressure at node 5 has been maintained at the 20 psi gauge, which in turn maintains a higher pressure at node 3. Hovering over the back pressure valve, we can see the reported pressure loss introduced is 45.69 feet head. In this video, we also wanted to discuss some common modelling mistakes when using Pipeflow Expert. The modelling of flow control valves, pressure reducing valves, and back pressure valves requires that the flow rates and pressures from adjacent pipes must be used as a reference to establish the pressure loss that the control valves must introduce. To allow this, a control valve cannot be added to any pipe where an adjoining pipe already includes a control valve. To get around this, you could split the following pipe into two and add the control valve to the second section, essentially adding a pipe in between. Another common issue is when a control valve has been set to a demand that cannot be met. Looking at the PRV example again, we saw that the maximal pressure at the node was around 70 psi. If we set the PRV pressure setting to be higher than the maximum pressure, say 75 psi gauge, then the system will not be solved. And this is identified in the log here. As we saw, all three types of valves work by essentially introducing a pressure loss to achieve the desired flow or pressure requirement set. Control valves cannot introduce a negative pressure loss or add pressure like a pump would. If when trying to calculate your system, it was found that the valve would need to add pressure, it would not be possible to identify a valid solution. The control valve setting will have to be amended, or the flow control valve may have to be removed entirely to allow the solution to be calculated. We hope you found this video on modelling control valves in Pipeflow Expert useful, and thanks again for watching.